Well, the 100 Mile Yard Sale is here. The annual event on Highway Southeast Missouri stretches
in my part of the world right now. The weather is improving, and usually that means that there are garage sales, yard sales, or whatever you want to call them, popping up every weekend. However, I think that a trend or tradition is being lost. I seem to run across fewer each year, and the chance of finding great items for a bargain is pretty slim, since a lot of people seem to think that pricing on par with eBay is reasonable. And when you do find a deal, sometimes things aren't in the best condition. I picked up a few PlayStation games last year that were in terrible shape. One was a counterfeit, and two, Medieval and Crash Team Racing, were unplayable due to damage. A waste of money, right? I think I only paid $5 for the three, but still, I was looking forward to playing these. I remember renting Crash Team Racing as a kid and thought it was pretty great. So is there anything that can be done? Well, sure, depending on the severity of the damage and where it is on the disc. I've managed to read some terrible, even cracked discs over the years. But you don't need to try and track down a new old stock CD repair system or bust out tubes of minty scented toothpaste or polished grade sandpaper. Those DIY solutions are all but guaranteed to destroy your media even more. And with these types of fixes, there's often no second chance since you're scuffing up the read surface even more. Here I'll go over how to repair some moderate disc damage to the read surface and some minor damage to the painted label, and use some software to examine the disc for read errors. It can be difficult to see damage, so you may find it easier to reflect the light at an angle until the scratches become more visible, or use a flashlight. As light passes through the disc, it hits the reflective surface and then reflects back through the pressed layer to represent the data. Damage to the read surface obscures the light passing through, and damage to the reflective surface prevents light from being reflected back through the sandwich data layer. I'd suggest using a bright lamp or flashlight to make things easier. As you can see, this disc has some seriously bad swirl scratches. I think someone attempted to repair this before using toothpaste or something. There was a chalky white material around the ring, so I think that's what happened here. There is also a bad scuff, but it's thankfully not a deep scratch. Those will cause the light to be reflected in random directions. If you can rub your fingernail over the scratch and it doesn't catch, it's probably fixable. Some scratches are irrelevant though. There may be areas of the disc that aren't used, so it may be worthwhile to use software to scan the disc and report back just what the errors are. It's tough to recommend a specific application for this because they're all very old and tend to require specific optical drives. Two that have worked well for me in the past are Nero DiscSpeed and QPXTool. I've linked both down below and suggest that you use the link for DiscSpeed as others tend to be packaged with some sort of adware annoyance. As for the optical drives, I think the one in my Dell Latitude E6500 laptop works well for this, and supports C1 and C2 error reporting. If yours doesn't, you can still use DiscSpeed for read tests. The benchmark will read the entire disc, attempting to read various speeds and do a point sample reads. This is helpful if the disc has a lot of minor scratches, as these can be bypassed using the data repair checksum built into the CD. These are the C1 errors. These slow down the disc's read speed, and in some console games can cause stuttering and frame drops. The disc quality scan will scan the disc for errors. C1 errors are minor and correctable, and C2 errors are more severe and may or may not be correctable. As cool as this graph looks, you want as few blue lines as possible, and even fewer yellow lines. None is ideal. As you see, the swirly scratches led to a lot of C1 errors, and the C2 errors are probably the big scuff somewhere, which would make sense because it's closer to the outer surface of the disc. ScanDisc will read the data sector by sector in the read test, and will do a sector by sector error scan in the other test type, but I'm unclear on how this really differs from the disc quality scan aside from just being represented differently. So the Medieval disc seems to be showing a few bad blocks in a similar region as the disc quality scan. And I guess that's why this is unplayable. So now we'll try and do something about it. The first thing I need to do is look at the rest of the disc to make sure I don't damage things more trying to repair it. This PlayStation disc is 25 years old and has probably been treated and stored poorly. The ink on the surface protects the silver reflective layer and some of it is missing. So first thing, I want to give the disc a wipe with some window cleaning solution, and then let it dry. And then use some quick drying clear acrylic nail polish to cover the scratch. Use at least two layers, spread about as thin as the ink layer, and let each dry before proceeding on to the next. And then carefully wipe any dust or debris from the disc. After that, I take a moist paper towel and place it in the jewel case to secure the disc. For scratch removal, there are only a couple products that I can recommend with any degree of success. Other things can work, but I've had inconsistent results. Meguiar's ultimate compound is abrasive, but the compound is smooth and very fine particulate. It's used for buffing out scratches in automobile bumpers and things like that. It's also pretty good at removing ink from non-absorbent surfaces. I've used it on glossy paper to remove Sharpie marker very carefully with a cotton swab, and one bottle will last a long time. It should be available anywhere with a well-stocked automotive department or on Amazon. For buffing, I suggest using a microfiber cloth or clean cotton. You'll want something that soaks up some of the compound rather than having it slosh around on the surface. This will concentrate the abrasive particles and make this go much faster. And if I make this look difficult, it really isn't. My arthritis is pretty bad, but this was no trouble. Just let your shoulder do the work and rub in small circles around the area of the scratches. Use the dry parts of the cloth to remove any used compound, and then check the quality of the disc periodically. Try to avoid getting any of the compound in the spindle hole. It can be tough to get out from the seams in the disc. In the past, I would have just said run the disc under water to rinse the excess, but as this plastic is getting old, getting water in the seam can cause it to expand and crack. I'm going to give it another good wipe down to remove any polishing compound, and then I'll pop it in the computer and run out of the scan and we'll see how we did. Well, after a few minutes of polishing, I've managed to reduce the number of C1 errors from a total of about 32,000 to 13,000 and managed to completely eliminate the C2 errors from that scuff. The surface scan shows a few damaged blocks, but nothing unrecoverable. And the error scan completes with no bad sectors, so this should read well on a PlayStation with a decently working laser. Filming my PS3 is going to be a bit of a pain, so I'm going to try to make a disk image with ImgBurn, which previously failed, and then try loading the ISO in the EPSXE emulator. Hey, look at that, it works great. And the actual disc does play in my PS3 as well. Though I'll probably dump it to an ISO there as well, so I don't put too much mileage on that aging disc drive. The same method will work for audio CDs and DVDs as well. However, audio CDs are much more prone to skipping if they have fine scratches. Portable players will often struggle to fill the anti-shock buffer, though I'm sure there aren't many other lunatics carting around a disc bin these days. Hopefully some of this helps save those damaged discs that may be laying around. If you found any of this useful, please hit the like button or leave a comment. Tell me about the worst condition CD you've ever repaired or just where you're watching from. It's tough to get these kinds of videos to show up on YouTube, and your comments, likes, and shares really help boost them up. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.